Taking into account pressure, density, and wind direction, we can put together what is happening across the globe. So this video lecture focuses on the global circulation. Draw with me. We're going to draw the Earth and go ahead and put in our latitudes, 0 degrees, 30 degrees, 60 degrees, and then finally 90 degrees, which is the North Pole. And go ahead and draw in the latitudes, the primary latitudes, for the Southern Hemisphere. Hovering around the equator, just kind of floating and then migrating, meandering around the equator, is the ITCZ. ITCZ. This is the Intertropical Convergence Zone. Intertropical Convergence, 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 coming together, zone. This is influenced by the direct ray of the sun. It is the result of the direct ray of the sun. So this is a low pressure. The ITCZ, convergence, is a low pressure. So you've got warm air rising. The ITCZ influences the distribution of rainforests because it's constantly raining. The ITCZ is a complex of thunderstorms and rain showers that goes around the entire world. So anytime that you see a rainforest on land, it is the result of the ITCZ. Now the ITCZ migrates with the sun, as do all the other pressure belts that we will talk about here momentarily. So the ITCZ influences the distribution of rainforests around the world. If we can go north and to the south, hovering around 30 degrees north and 30 degrees south is the STHP. STHP, which is the subtropical high pressure belt. It is the subtropical high pressure belt. Underneath this, you have air that is sinking and diverging. So this is an area of divergence. The ITCZ was an area of convergence, coming together, diverging, and then converging. The STHP influences the distribution of deserts. So one particular desert that the STHP creates is the Sahara Desert. The STHP is the high pressure. Now if we go one step north and south, to 60 degrees north and 60 degrees south, we get another low pressure. And this low pressure is not as strong as the ITCZ because you have a loss of energy. There's a loss of energy going north and going to the south. So this is called the SPLP. SPLP. The subpolar low pressure. This is what helps bring us our precipitation. And so this influences more of our weather. So this is the subpolar low pressure, and it migrates and it meanders around the 60 degrees north. Again, all of these pressure belts, if the sun is in the northern hemisphere during the winter, the summer solstice, everything shifts to the north to go with it. In the winter solstice, the sun is now in the southern hemisphere. All of these pressure belts move to the south. They migrate to the south. They follow the sun. All right, now we have at 90 degrees north and 90 degrees south, we have the polar high, the polar high. This is a high pressure belt, or really a major high pressure cell. And it hovers around the poles due to the lack of insulation throughout the year. We only get insulation in part of the year. All right, so these are the pressure belts. To reiterate, this is the ITCZ, the Intertropical Convergence Zone. It is a complex, it is a band of complex thunderstorms and rain showers that it is a result of the direct ray of the sun. And outside of that is the STHP, the subtropical high pressure. The ITCZ influences the distribution of rainforests, while the subtropical high pressure influences the distribution of deserts around the world. The subpolar low pressure is at 60 degrees north and 60 degrees south and brings us our weather in the northern hemisphere. And then finally, at the poles, we have the polar highs. Now, the wind belts are the result of these differences in pressure. So in between these pressure belts, we have winds. We go from high to low, high to low, high to low, high to low. This wind belt is the northeast trade winds. The northeast trade winds. The winds are coming from the northeast and moving toward the equator, toward the ITCZ. Diverging air, converging air. Diverging air, converging air. In the southern hemisphere, we get a mirror image of this. So we get now the southeast trade winds. The southeast trade winds. The southeast trade winds move from the subtropical high pressure in the southern hemisphere at 30 degrees south and move toward the ITCZ. So we get northeast trade winds, southeast trade winds. And all of these, the wind moves from the high pressure belt to the low pressure belt. On the northern hemisphere, between 30 degrees north and 60 degrees north, we get another wind belt that goes from the subtropical high pressure to the subpolar low pressure. And these are called the westerlies. The westerlies are what brings us our weather. Our weather moves from west to east, west to east. In the southern hemisphere, it's a mirror image, again, from the subtropical high pressure to the subpolar low pressure. And these are called, again, the westerlies. And we go in between 90 degrees north and 60 degrees north. We have a polar high at the pole, and then we have a low pressure at 60 degrees north. So we go from high to low, high to low. And these are called the polar easterlies. Winds are moving from high to the low pressure, which is the subpolar low pressure. And same thing here. We have polar easterlies that move, the winds move from the high to the low. And these again are the polar easterlies. So these are the wind belts and pressure belts, and this is global circulation. Now we're going to look at it a different way. We're going to look at a cross section as if we did this. We're going to take a slice out of this and look at it. What is happening at the surface and aloft? So we start with 0 and 30 degrees north, 60 degrees, and 90 degrees. And then we have, this is north and this is south, 30 degrees south, 60 and 90. What's at the equator? The ITCZ, so it's a low pressure. It is a low pressure, low pressure. Then we go from the equator to the 30 degrees north and 30 degrees south. That's the high pressure. That's the subtropical high pressure. This is the ITCZ. And then we go again, 60 degrees north and 60 degrees south. We have the low pressure, which is the subpolar low pressure. Subpolar low pressure here. And then at the surface, the polar high is at 90 degrees. So we have alternating pressures. So let's put in what happens between these pressures at the surface. We have air that moves from high to low, high to low, high to low. At 30 degrees south to 60 degrees south, we have air that moves from high to low, creating the subpolar low pressure. Same here, high to low. And then vice versa, 90 degrees north to 60 degrees north, we have air moving from high to low. And here, high to low. Now, let's consider what happens aloft. Let's go ahead and draw in our tropopause. TP is the tropopause. It's the lid of the lower atmosphere. So we have, when we have converging air at the surface, it's got to go somewhere based on Dyne's principle of compensation. So therefore, it rises and creates an area of divergence. Remember, that balloon, that water balloon, throw it up into the ceiling, and instead of just coming in together, it spreads out. So you have an area of divergence. Air will move out from that. Then, just above the high pressures, you have an area of convergence. Convergence, where you have sinking air that creates that high pressure. Sinking, cold, dense air, creating the high pressure at the surface. Now go ahead and fill in the rest of these. You have air that moves from an area of divergence because you have rising air above the low. Rising air above the low creates divergence. Air is moving from the divergence to the convergence in both cases. And then again, air is moving out from the divergence aloft to the area of convergence. That air is coming together. Air is coming together and sinks to create a high pressure. Here, converging air sinks to create a high pressure at the surface. So that's what's happening across the world from 0 degrees to 90 degrees. Now, one most important aspect of this is called the Hadley cells. The Hadley cells are a major convective unit controlled by the direct ray of the sun. The Hadley cells, and so we have here, so it's easy for you to remember, we have Mr. Hadley's head with his eyes as the convective unit. Mr. Hadley's head. And these are the Hadley cells. The Hadley cells that are major unit based on the insulation at the equator. The ITCZ is the center of that. The high pressure is just outside it. You do not get a major convective unit in these other cells, although they are weaker. The major Hadley cell is here hovering in the tropics.